Okay, good evening, guys. Today I want us to check on our class's lecture. We're talking about Microsoft Excel, I think. Then I want us to do a live lecture so that you can cover up the stuff that we didn't cover in class, right? So maybe without any waste of time, I'm just going to open in my Microsoft Excel in here, and then I'm also gonna open the slides. I think they are in where are they? I think they are in drive A, and then in drive A I'm gonna go to what do we have? It's IRTM. Okay, I think we have them in here. Spreadsheets and then Microsoft Excel. What I want us to do, I want to demonstrate how do we insert data into a spreadsheet Excel or maybe a spreadsheet program, and then also work with the spreadsheet program, and then maybe try to save, maybe try to look into the report, try to maybe cover up some stuff that we didn't cover in class. Because what we did in class was that we did a welcome, which was opening a spreadsheet like this one, which is what I'm just doing in here. We did this in class, right? We have seen this screen. I think you can recall. I said these are templates, and the templates what you are doing in here, you are just looking for anything that you want to do, which is if maybe let me say you want to do a pivot table, you're going to this one. If maybe you want to create a pie chart or something, you're just going to go to with this one. Maybe you want to anything in here, maybe a student schedule, maybe it's a report, invoice in here, anything. But then what we're going to do today, we're just going to do everything from scratch, which is this one, right? But then let me just go back and then check on our slides in here, which are these ones. So we said we are going to be checking into working with the ribbon, demonstrating where the ribbon is, and then maybe managing our worksheets, and then entering data, which is entering data is it's gonna be what we are going to be doing, entering data in different time intervals, right? But then we are going to cover it. We are going to state it, describe, maybe explain everything, and then maybe you are going to see it as we are doing it. All right, excuse me. So for now, let me just jump straight into working with the ribbon, try to explain something with the ribbon, and then we are going to go on after that. So let me just go straight to the blank workbook which we talked about in class. We said this is a blank workbook. We see that it is a blank workbook by that it starts everything from scratch. There is no designed or predefined formatting or any adjustments that have been made in here. We have anything starting from scratch. That is why we know it's a blank workbook, right? So we said with Microsoft Office, all of these are Microsoft Office applications that we are going to be talking about in class, or that we are going to be learning about, they have this thing what we call a similarities, right? They have this with this bar from here, this bar. Let me just try to highlight it for you so that you can see this bar that I'm talking about. This bar from here, which way? Where does this thing start? It starts in here. Here, right? This is the bar that we call it a ribbon. As you can see, the ribbon has got what we call a different number of tabs. Yes, we have got what we call the file tab, which is this one, where we're gonna be managing our workbook using the file tab, right? We can be creating a new workbook, we can be maybe opening, if we want, we have a workbook that is in here, and then we didn't finish working on it, then we want to reopen it, we're going to choose open. We can be saving our workbook, we can save a copy of our workbook in here if you want to save it as a different maybe with a different name or in a different location. We are going to use this one. We can be able to print our book in here. We can be able to share it, export it. when I'm talking about exporting it, I mean like this file is an Excel file, right? But if you want to export it, maybe you want to change the format, maybe to a PDF format or something else, this is what exporting. Publishing basically works with or if you want to send it maybe online or something like that, or if you want to publish or post it online, you can just click it in here, it's published. It says publish to Power BI. When I publish to Power BI, it is going to give me these options, which is maybe uploading or maybe exporting, depending with what I'm going to use. Of course, here I'm going to need to use my emails to publish this, because this is something that is going to go online, right? And then we also have accounts in here on options, but then this is what important. This is what we are going to be using most of the time: export, share, print, save as, and save and new and open. These are the ones that we are going to go with in class. So that's the file. Home is where we manage everything, or every data that's in here. We can maybe like change font size, or like if I type in here like Freeman, and then I want to change font size for Freeman, maybe I can choose a bigger font size. What is happening here? Why is it taking so long? I just need to choose a bigger font size. As you can see, okay, this one is too big. It's just that you can't see it. This is what happens. I've just chosen a bigger font size here, which is size 36, right? Okay, you can also choose a different font family in here, but then I don't want to do it right now. So I'm just demonstrating how do we use the font, the ribbon. The ribbon here, everything in here is your tool. We are going to be using these tools each and every day. Maybe when we are doing Excel, we are going to be inserting things in here, maybe external media or something that we are going to be needing to use in here. My charts, maybe pie charts, bar graphs, anything that we are going to be needing to use, even formulas. Sometimes we are going to use here. My equations and symbols, we are going to use these ones to insert in here, maybe then here, my page layouts. Page layout is controlling the page when we want to print. Like when we, can I just demonstrate to set print area? When I set print area, unfortunately, I have nothing that is in here. But if I had information that is good, that wasn't here, when setting the print area, I was going to get something like this. Yeah, there was going to be a line in here which shows that this is the area that is going to be printed out. And it's everything that is in this side is gonna be cut out. It's gonna be cut off. That I think you understand. That is why when people are printing, maybe are printing things and stuff, some people will find that they cut some things out. When you say, you've cut my, maybe someone was creating your birthday card and then they have cut it out, it's because they did insert it in here in the error, right? In formulas, this is one of the tips that we are going to be using here, like let me say, most frequently. Yes, because we are going to be using functions and formulas most often. So we must make sure that you understand all the formulas in here. Try to use a different number of formulas in here. And then view and data, maybe these ones are they are not much important, but you are going to be needing to use them. We are not going to be talking about them a lot in here, but you will use them. This this one which says tell me what to do, we this is what we call something like Finder in Microsoft Excel. What basically it helps you to find anything that you didn't see, or maybe that's something that you are not seeing in here, right? If you maybe want to bold some text, right, like this one, I have my name, right, this one, right? I want to bold it, but I do not see where to bold my text in here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just going to type in here bold like this, and then click in here. Automatically, when I click it is gonna bold this and then highlight to me where can I find the bold or the bolding 2, right? As you can see, my name is now bold than it's bolder than that one that I typed in before. So that's how we use the report. It's your toolbox, it's your friend, you're going to be using it. Everything that you are doing in here is a related, or maybe it's from here. It's you this is the palette that you're going to be using to control anything that you're doing in your spreadsheets, right? So maybe let us just touch on a few shortcuts of using Excel, like this one. If I just highlight or maybe hover over my text in here, in this small square, this one, I will see this black plus sign. When I click and drag this black plus sign, I'm just going to copy everything that is in here into the following sets, like this one. I've just copied everything. My name has been copied to all these adjacent sets, right? This is going to be handy when we are working with the functions and formulas in our points of sale system, right? So I was just demonstrating a few shortcuts. The next shortcut is in here is that it happens sometimes that you have your cursor in here and then you want to go to this set, not this one, right? Maybe you are here, maybe you're typing like something like the here name, and then you want to go to this next set, right? Maybe you are going to type in here surname like this, right? And then you want to go like this, and then maybe here you are going to be typing like page like this one. So to do that thing, what you do is you type whatever you type, and then do not click enter, but you click what we call tab in your keyboard. It's tab, not enter. When you click enter, you are going to the cell that is below, which means it is this one. But then when you click tab, you are going to the cell that is following on your left, or maybe let me say on your right. I think you will understand this when you do a lot of practice. When you just play around with enter and tab, say that enter is this and then tab is this one. I think those are the basic shortcuts. Otherwise, if you want to highlight everything, you just click in here, and when you see the bigger plus, and then you click and drag, this is highlighting. But when you want to copy, we said you were just going to use this black plus. This one is for copying, and this one is for, or this one, the bigger one is for highlighting. As you can see, this one is not copying, but it highlights. But the smaller one, this one, the black one, it's copying. Now we have names, not the my name. I think you are seeing this. So we have talked about the ribbon. We said the ribbon helps us, it's a toolbox that helps us to work around it and modify, maybe in the edit anything that is in here or in our spreadsheets, right? So we are going to check on the next topic, which is managing Emma worksheets right now. But let me just cut this video so that it can be short, so that you can be able to follow along in any other video that I've been recording prior this one. So I think let me just check you in the following video. For now, I'll let me say bye. Where is this? And where is the